So I'm going to start this video a little bit different today. No fancy product shots. I feel like I just have to jump right into this here. So right here I have the Gerber Lockdown Drive, and right here is the Gerber Lockdown Pry. The Drive has 8 tools and the Pry has 10 tools. Both of these are $51 each. Now I've had both of these since release. I've just been sitting on them trying to figure out how I'm going to rate these tools in this video, and I've come to a conclusion. And my conclusion is, what the heck is going on over there at Gerber regarding their multi-tools? I'm serious. Maybe somebody should go over to Gerber and check on them, make sure they're okay, because I don't know what they were thinking when they released these multi-tools. And I'm not saying all their multi-tools are bad or knives. I actually do like some of their things, but recently, and I'm looking right at you, Gerber Armbar, I just don't know what they were thinking, and we'll get to this very, very shortly. But first, let's compare the sizes here. So wide, the Drive is 1.09, and the Pry is 1.09. So they're exactly the same width. Thickness, the Drive is 0.57, and the Pry is 0.58. So the Pry is just slightly thicker. And now let's weigh these. So I have the Drive right here. It comes in at 5.1 ounces, and that is 144 grams. The Pry here comes in at, whoa, all right, okay, 5.9 ounces, 6 ounces, let's just say, and that is 168 grams. So these are not light multi-tools at all. Looks like the Pry is a little bit heavier than the Drive here. So let's start talking about these. Let's start here with the Drive. So the Drive has 8 tools, and you can see it looks pretty nice. I don't have a problem with the aesthetics at all. Actually, I do like the design here. They both have a decent deep carry pocket clip here. Fits nicely into your pocket. It's not thick at all. And I do like the tools that they have here. Like I said, the Drive has 8 tools. It has a 2.5 inch plain edge, and that is right here. In 1 second. And you're gonna see why I have issues with this multi-tool right here. And it's just deploying the tools is almost impossible. I'll get to that in a minute, but right here is the 2.5 inch plain edge, and they say it's a frame lock, but that's not a frame lock. That is a liner lock. And another issue I have with these tools is just how difficult and strong this lock is right here to disengage the tools once they are deployed. I mean, I literally tear up my thumb every single time I deploy or try to retract these tools back into the body here, just because of how strong everything is. Starting with how insanely strong the detent is here, just even trying to deploy anything. The detent doesn't need to be this strong. All it has to do is just hold the tools in the place securely, not permanently, Gerber. So these are so difficult to deploy, and it's almost to the point where I feel like I'm gonna cut myself trying to deploy this, especially one-handed, because what you have to do, you can see the tab right here, is push down and out. And the tab that they put on these multi-tools is damn near useless. You can see there's hardly anything right there to grab onto with your thumb. So they're saying these are one-handed multi-tools, and I just have to disagree. So that being said, if I can't deploy these one-handed, why do we need this large obnoxious tab on each one of these tools? Because it just takes up surface space. They could have easily just put a nail nick on each one of these tools. Here we go. And we won't have this gigantic, obnoxious, ugly looking tab on each one of these tools here. Sorry, I kind of went off there a little bit, but you guys now understand why I have issues with these tools. But let's get back to the actual tools here. I like this 2.5 inch plain edge right here. I just don't like the tab right here. I think it just takes up surface space and it affects the performance, especially for cutting cardboard boxes. Once the cardboard hits this tab, it jams up. And I really don't like that, but this knife right out of the box is insanely sharp. I mean, this thing is super sharp right out of the box. I mean, I can just shave paper if I wanted here. And you can see that's not my issue at all. I do like the plain edge. I just don't like how it deploys or how it retracts back into the body here. I think this is terrible. And it's so sharp right here. That is actually really sharp. Just tears up your thumb every single time. Next, let's look at this file right here. And I actually like this file, but not as a file. I absolutely love this chisel edge right here. It's really sharp, and I've been using it as a scraper, and it works fantastic. But this side is supposed to be the aggressive side. This is the cross cut. And the fine side right here, just the straight cuts, almost non-existent. I know it's supposed to be a fine edge file, but it is almost non-existent. I don't like this as a file at all. As a chisel or a scraper, sorry, has that chisel edge, but as a scraper, I think this is fantastic. It is a nice thick steel right here, and I think it works great as a scraper. But let's move on, and I have the same issue with this lock mechanism. It's just so stiff and difficult to unlock the tools and put it back into the body. But let's move on here. Now, the one tool that I don't have any issues opening one-handed is this awl right here. As you can see, I can very easily open it one-handed because the detent isn't nearly as strong on this awl as the other tools. But check out this awl. This is really nice. Super sharp point right here. Has a semi-sharp edge. I mean, it's not going to cut you, but I think this is still a very nice awl or reamer. But once again, that gigantic ugly tab right there, I think it just affects the performance. I don't like these big ugly plastic tabs right here. And on top of that, I don't think they work well. But let's move on to the next tool here. And oh my God, if you don't have nails, which I don't here, these are almost impossible. I can't even get this out. There we go. This is what I'm talking about. I almost poked myself with this utility blade right here, just trying to get these out just because of how strong that detent is. And you can see it does have a nice little semi half stop right there. You can hear the detent right there grabbing onto it. But let's check out this utility blade. I actually like this too. I think this is a pretty useful tool to have on this multi-tool. But it's almost to the point where I know I'm gonna cut myself with this tool sooner or later, and I'm surprised I haven't yet. And just trying to get this tool out was a good example of why I don't like this. It's almost to the point where it's dangerous, I think, where, come, this is ridiculous. I can't even get it out with two hands, and they're claiming this is a one-handed tool. But now let's move on to the last tool on here that I was really excited about, and that is the driver right here. And once again, I don't know why Gerber didn't put a locking mechanism other than a slip joint on this driver. Now, don't get me wrong, it is leaps and bounds better than the trash garbage fire that we saw on the Gerber armbar. The Gerber armbar, I didn't like at all. The slip joint is non-existent on this tool. The driver on the armbar is almost useless and one of the worst I've ever seen, in my opinion. Some of you might disagree with me. It's just my opinion, but look at this. I mean, there is no lock on this at all. So at least they give us somewhat of a locking slip joint. You can see this is already leaps and bounds better than the armbar, but still not great. Why Gerber refuses to give us a locking driver is beyond me. Obviously, they know there was an issue with the armbar here, so they gave us a little bit better of a slip joint right here, a pretty strong detent, but it's still useless in my opinion. Now, let's check out this quarter bit right here. I've seen reviewers that had really strong magnets and issues getting this out one-handed, or sorry, just with your fingers without having to pry it out with a tool. But you can see mine is actually pretty perfect. I don't have an issue with the strength of this magnet at all. And they gave us a flathead and a Phillips quarter inch bit for this, which I don't have an issue with this at all. Actually, I would really like this if it was just a locking driver. And deploying the driver one-handed works, but it's still not ideal. You can see I can still roll my thumb over. It just tears up your thumb a lot, just like every other tool in this. And you can see it has these little ridges, this jimping right here to help your thumb deploy this driver. But it's still not the greatest design in the world, I think. And now let's move on to the Gerber Lockdown Pry. And this is the one I was really looking forward to because I carry an EDC pry bar, and that would basically free up a spot in my pocket because it has a prier right here at the end, along with scissors and the straight edge, sorry, the plain edge. So did it deliver? No, it has the same issues as the Lockdown Drive. But I will say that these tools are much easier to deploy one-handed because they actually use a different tab on the pry than on the drive here. And I'll try to give you guys a nice close-up. You can see the tab on the drive is very, very shallow. There's not a lot of room to get your thumb in there to deploy the tools. But here on the pry, you can see there's much more of a lip right there, and it's a lot easier to get your thumb there, a lot more room to get the tools out. And that's very confusing to me. Why wouldn't they use the same tab on both multi-tools? They are definitely different, and that just confuses me. So let's start with the scissors. You can see I can get the scissors out one-handed, but look at this. I don't know why they chose to do this either with the scissors. So there's a, you open it, there's a stopping point right there, another stopping point not too far after that, another stopping point about halfway open, and then it freely opens up. And these scissors are pretty decent. They're no Victorinox scissors. You can see they cut just fine. Maybe the best tool on this, or either one of these tools, are these retractable spring action scissors. But once again, the tab on here kind of gets in the way, especially when you're cutting. You can see when you're cutting right there on the bottom, the tab kind of gets caught on the paper. And it's just a stupid design, in my opinion. I hate these tabs on either one of these multi-tools. I just don't understand it. All right, let's just move on. I'm just gonna keep going on about these tabs. But let's move on to the next tool right here. And of course, that's the utility tool. Same exact deal that we saw on the drive here, except that it's a little bit easier to deploy in this because of the tab right here. It's just, it gives us more room to grab onto. Still not ideal, but it's just a little bit better than what we saw over there on the drive. The next tool we have here is the exact same file as we saw on the drive. Cross cuts here, the fine straight cuts right here with a very nice scraper. This chiseled edge I think is fantastic. And now let's move on to the 2.5-inch plain edge. It's just tearing up my thumbs, man. I cannot get this out one-handed just with my thumb. So I'm gonna have to get my fingernail under there. There we go. Same exact deal, 2.5 inches. Very, very sharp, but I know it's just inevitable. I'm going to end up cutting myself trying to get this out one-handed one day. So let's just hope that doesn't happen. So now let's move on to the prying capabilities of the Lockdown Pry. And this is by far my favorite feature of the Lockdown Pry. And let me tell you, it's heartbreaking because I really wanted to like this tool just because of this feature. And then they took out a little notch right there in the prier that gives us a nail puller. And on each side of that nail puller, we have a small flathead screwdriver and a large flathead screwdriver, which I think a lot of us would have used this as a flathead screwdriver in a pinch anyways. But regardless, it's there. I do like this prier on this tool. That is by far not my issue with any one of these tools. I'm just baffled at the logic of putting these tabs here and saying it's a one-handed multi-tool when the detent is so strong, I literally cannot even open it, sometimes even with two hands. Good luck trying to open any one of these tools if you don't even have the slightest bit of a thumbnail, because you have to get your thumb in there so deep and push, my God, and push so hard to deploy this blade. I just don't understand it. So my suggestion to Gerber is, if you're gonna make this a one-handed tool by putting these tabs here, don't make the detent so strong. And if you are going to make this detent strong, we don't need these tabs because we're gonna have to use two hands to open these tools anyway. So in that case, just give us a nail nick and redesign this tool completely, because then we don't need this ugly tab on here affecting our performance when cutting or whatever. I just don't like these tabs. I don't like the strength of this liner lock right here. It's extremely hard to unlock each one of these tools. And every time I do, it feels like I'm gonna cut my finger wide open. And if the lock doesn't cut my finger wide open, it's trying to deploy these tools one-handed, and I feel like I'm gonna slip one day and just slice the heck out of my finger. Because look at this. This is what I'm talking about. If I push, I know I keep saying this over and over again, but look how close I am to the edge of this blade. It's a silly design. I don't like it, and I 100% do not recommend these tools to anybody.